You had seen they had cartilaginous endoskeleton. Here they are having bony endoskeleton. Then their body is streamlined, you know, streamlined body, this shape. This is streamlined. Mouth is mostly terminal. Terminal matlab yahan pe this part. So the mouth is mostly terminal. They have four pairs of gills which are covered by an operculum on each side. So in the previous one you had seen, were the gills covered by operculum? In chondrocytes, were they covered by operculum? Not covered. Here they are covered by operculum. So in this bony fishes, the gills are covered by operculum on each side. Skin is covered with cycloid or tenoid scales. This is cycloid scale. This is how it looks like. Cycloid, like cyclic rings are there. That's why cycloid. And here they are having tenoid scales. This is the way how tenoid scales are seen. So skin is either covered with cycloid or tenoid scales. As I told you yesterday, when you were small, you used to write, draw a fish, and then uske upar aise aise karke, you used to draw the designs, no? So those are the scales, the cycloid scales and tenoid scales. Air bladder is present. So yesterday we were talking about air bladder. Like we were talking about when air bladder is not present, what was shark use, like fishes like shark, what do they do? When air bladder, they keep on swimming, isn't it? So here air bladder is present. So they are, which help them to regulate buoyancy. Buoyancy you have heard in physics. What is buoyancy? Sheikh Muzammil Basha, tell me. Okay, like if you keep a bottle filled with water into the water, the bottle will float on it, isn't it? So that's again because of buoyancy. So here air bladder is present, because of which they will not sink down. They can float or they can move in water. Then heart is two chambered, one auricle and one ventricle. So fishes, you see, they are having two chambered heart. They are cold-blooded animals. Yesterday we had seen this. What was the other term for this cold-blooded animal? Another term? Yes. What does it mean? What does it mean, cold-blooded animal means? Yes. They cannot regulate their body temperature according to their atmosphere. So they are cold-blooded animals. Sexes are separate. They are having male and female separate. Fertilization is usually external. They are mostly oviparous. So yesterday we had seen oviparous, viviparous. Oviparous matlab they lay eggs. Oviparous lay eggs. Viviparous give birth to the. Okay, so here fishes. So they are mostly oviparous. Then development is direct. It's not indirect. The development is direct. That is, the larva will look like the adult. Example hai iska, marine fishes, when we talk about exocetus, which are called flying fish. Okay, hippocampus, seahorse. Seahorse you might have seen when you were small, you might have heard about it. Hippocampus, that is the scientific name for that. Then freshwater fishes, labio rohu. This mostly people eat rohu fish. Labio rohu, this also Catla also people eat. Catla, Clarius, Magur. These are all pictures of it, which is not given in your textbook. I'm just showing you so that you know it. They are Magur. Then aquarium. How many, anybody has aquarium at home? Nobody? No one has aquarium at home? Nobody interested in keeping fishes? Okay. So in aquarium you might have seen, if you have seen somewhere aquarium, you might have seen there are different colored fishes inside, no? So they all belong to this category. So this is fighting fish. Beta, fighting fish. So they, inside the aquarium, they can fight. So they are fighting fish. That is why they are called fighting fish. This also you might have seen in aquariums. They are angel fish. Apart from this, other fishes are also seen, no, in aquarium, if you have seen. So this is angel fish, which is called pterophyllum. These you mostly find in aquarium. So what are the examples? We had seen exocetus, hippocampus, freshwater mein labio, that is rohu, catla, clarius or magur. Then aquarium, beta, that is fighting fish, and pterophyllum, which is angel fish. So this is about ostriches. So what are, what all the things that we have seen? They are commonly bony fishes. What type of endoskeleton do they have? What type of endoskeleton? Shape of the body? Shape of the body? Mouth is. Mouth, where is the mouth? How many chambered heart? Fertilization? Fertilization is external, development is direct. Oviparous or viviparous? Oviparous. Are the gills covered? Are the gills? Yes. Covered by? Then what else? What type of scales do they have? What are they? Two type of scales? Cycloid or actinoid. Cold blooded or warm blooded? What helps them in buoyancy? Examples of marine fish. In aquarium, fighting fish, beta or beta. Angelfish. Okay. Then freshwater fishes. Okay, good. So that's about osteocytes and chondrocytes. Just have a look at the video, then we will continue.